Very good morning, judges, my dear friends and colleagues. I'll be speaking on doing phacoemulsifications by two methods, peribulbar anesthesia or topical anesthesia. Various type of, since cataract has evolved from ICC to phaco nowadays, there are various type of anesthesia being used in phacoemulsifications, right from peribulbar, retrobulbar, subtenous, intracameral, topical anesthesia. And ideal anesthetic, what aim should be? It should be a painless surgery without any systemic or local complications, and it should also be cost effective and should facilitate a comfortable procedure for surgeons as well. With advancement of phacoemulsifying machines and expertise of the surgeons, the duration of surgical procedure have become leisure, and as a result, search had been going on for a shorter acting anesthetic. While peribulbar anesthesia was common earlier, there has been a shift towards topical anesthesia nowadays. While topical is believed to have advantage over peribulbar anesthesia in terms of safety, pain-free, free of injection-related complications, it has the disadvantage of increased anxiety for the patients, and for a new surgeon, it is debatable to assign the supremacy of one type of anesthesia over the other. So it is just to clear this dilemma, we have conducted a study to investigate the merits and demerits of two techniques. It's a prospective study we have conducted from July 2019 to December 2019. All patients presenting with complaints of diminution of vision diagnosed with cataract were enrolled for the study. Written form consent were obtained from all the patients, and permission from ethic committee to the institutes was taken. Exclusion criteria were corneal opacity or complicated cataract without systemic morbidity. All patients underwent complete ophthalmic examinations. Patients were randomly divided in two groups by a mass distributor. Group 1 underwent peribulbar anesthesia and group underwent topical anesthesia. Group 1 had nearly 182 patients, while group 2 had 179 patients. All surgery was done by single surgeon by a standard technique of phacoemulsification of modified chop. Foldable IOL were implanted in all uneventful cases. If posterior capsule rupture occurred, then rigid IOL was implanted in the ciliary sulcus after enlarging the corneal incision to 6 mm. This wound was sutured with 10-0 silk, interrupted suture. Post-operative examinations were done on 1, 7, 30, and 45 days. Satisfaction score of the patients and surgeons were graded from lowest to highest in terms of 1 to 5. Intraoperative and posterior complications were noted. All data were entered in the Excel sheet, and the result were analyzed by a statistical package for social sciences version 18.0, where p-value more than 0.05 was considered statistically significant. The result distribution of patients in the total number of patients in group one was 182. Out of this, 95 were male, and group two, it was 93 male and 86 female. In group 1, as much as 172 patients reported less than 2, whereas only 13 patients' percentage score were more than 3, or more than 3. In group 2, as much as 134 patients reported less than 2 or 2 or less than 2, whereas 45% reported a score of more than 3 or 3. The post-operative surgeon satisfaction score of more than 3 in 133 patients and less than 2 or 2 in group 1. But among the group 2, patient satisfaction score were more than or equal to 3 was reported only in 9, and less than 2 in 166. Intraoperative complication were related in 86% of the patients in group 2 as compared to 35% in group 1. While intraoperative rupture of posterior capsule was noted in 35 patients whom postoperative macular edema developed in 23 in group 1, and 86% patient had rupture of posterior capsule in which 36 developed postoperative macular edema in group 2. Thus, conclusion is, while topical anesthesia initially is painless phase of surgical procedure, peribulbar result in laser intraoperative complication resulting better visual outcome. These are no funding as source, and there's no declared conflict of interest. So thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Very nice presentation, but I have a couple of questions. One is, you had almost 19% PC rent. Why is it so high?
The study done in my institute. I usually do topical surgery. But the person who was doing is just 3-year experienced phaco surgeon who has just passed out from a senior resident and become assistant professor now. Okay. So I tell her to put her data, not my data, topical and her data. So that's why it's a new surgeon.
So the topical was you and...
No. It's a single... She was only doing it, but she is more comfortable with peribulbar. So there might be a... It's a study goes if a new surgeon is different and an expert surgeon, topical anesthesia will be much better.
I think that's something you could have mentioned right up front.
Right.
It's a learning surgeon.
Right, sir.
And why did you use 10-0 silk to suture? I mean, nowadays everybody's using 10-0 nylon. No? I'm just curious.
We have in our institute usually ethylene available or 10-0 is available. 10-0 is the same. Ethylene 10-0 what we use.
So everybody. It's polypropylene. You mean polypropylene?
No, ma'am. It's ethylene. Ethylene means the silk, black silk. What is there available with the ethylene company?
That is 10-0 nylon.
Nylon, okay. Yeah.
So you mentioned the suture name.
Sutra, it was made of silk.
It's not silk, so, it's nylon.
It's nylon, right. 10-0 ethylene.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, everyone.